July, Tackle Club Baron Jack's Box, let's go. All right, so let's start off with the box breakdown list that is in every box. It tells you the retail price of each item in the box, as well as what the subscribers actually paid for it and what you're saving. But at the top of that is a little QR code, so you can open up the camera app on your phone, give that a scan, and it will open up a free e-mag, a fishing e-mag for free for Tackle Club subscribers. So don't forget to check that out. Now let's jump into the lures. Now I'm gonna start off with the biggest one in the box first, from our Australian mates at Baramba Lures. This is the Lazy Mullet. This is essentially a big swim bait, but it does come with a few other little bits and pieces in the packaging as well, allowing you to actually chop and change how this thing swims and how deep it swims. So it's got a little chamber in the front of its head, just underneath its chin here, allowing you to open it up and you can change it for a little plastic insert or a lead insert, causing it to sink a little bit deeper. So it's very, very versatile. Comes rigged with some pretty heavy duty strong hooks ready to go, so don't have to worry about the terminal tackle on here, so it's good to go straight out of the box. But with a swim bait, essentially what I'm gonna use this for, depending if I've got the lead weight or the plastic weight, if I've got the plastic weight, this is gonna be great up in the estuaries, so where you've got your mangroves and stuff, toss it in there and work it real slow back out. Make sure you add lots of pauses in, real slow wind, laughing. If you need to get down a little bit deeper, that's where you're gonna unscrew the chin bit underneath and put the lead weight in, causing this lure to sink down deeper so you can actually cover multiple parts of the water column. Fantastic design here by Matt Fraser at Baramba Lures with the Lazy Mullet. Moving over to two completely different styles of fishing lures as opposed to the swim bait. We've got one here from our mates at Chase Baits. So this is the Chase Baits Flick Prawn. So something super natural for the estuaries to fish. You can still use this in the dams as well. If you're fishing in the dams, I'm probably gonna look at using this around weed edges and stuff where there may be some freshwater shrimp hanging around. But in the estuaries, you're mimicking a prawn, a darting, fleeing, scared, but so, so delicious prawn. Easy to fish, cast it out, let it sink down. You can cast these into the snags because they are rigged weedless. So you can cast it into the snags, let it sink down. I like to do a couple little hops, pause, let it sink down, but keep the hops fairly small. You don't want to go ripping it out of the structure too quick because you want to keep it in the structure for as long as you can. Also look for your steep drop-offs if you've got a sounder as well. So if you've got like a shallow bank coming out to a drop-off where the tide may run out, try flicking in there. Looking for shadows and overhangs as well is a great place for this, because a lot of the time these fish, these Baron Jacks, will push the prawns and the bait fish up into the shallows or utilize the shadows to feed and hunt in. If you're moving around or want to pepper a lot of casts out and actually go searching essentially more, then you're going to jump over to the Samaki Reddick Jerkbait. This one here is an 80 mil suspending hard body. It is a deep diver. It's going to dive to around 3 meters, maybe a little bit more if you're fishing with a thinner braided line. But being suspending means that you can cast it up into your snag, give it a couple rips down, pause, and it'll just sit there. It won't float up and it won't start sinking down either. So in the winter time when it is colder, I do like to slow my retrieve down for this. So either just a couple rips down, long pause in the structure, then into like a slow to medium wind. Summertime, I'll probably get a bit more twitchy with it, add a few more twitches, twitch, twitch, speed it up with the retrieve. But in winter, I'm definitely going to slow it down. Add a lot of long pauses in there as well is a prime way to fish this in the colder months. And then to go with your lures, we've also added in some more fluorocarbon leader, something that every angler has to keep on them at all times, because this is what stops the fish from breaking your line or chafing it off on the rocks or the reef or the submerged timber. But super strong 50 pound stealth fluorocarbon from Platypus here to keep your line connected to your new lures. That's it for the Baron Jack's box this month. If you want to check it out or any of the others in the range, just head to www.tackleclub.com.au, pick a box that's right for you, and welcome to the club.